When you listen to electronic music and hear that drop, what's going on? What's the physics? What's the physiology? We're here at the Wonderfest studio to try to answer that question with Jack Conte, musician and YouTube phenom. Jack, can you help us out here? What's this about the drop?
Well, Tucker, I'm glad you asked. In Scary Monsters and Nice Sprites, when we get to that 45-second mark and Skrillex drops the bass, why does it sound so incredible? I think in order to figure that out, we have to know a little bit about how sound works. Let's start with the speaker. If you strip away the grill on the front of the speaker and you look at the actual guts of what's inside, you'll see something moving back and forth really quickly. This is a membrane, or the speaker cone. This membrane moves back and forth very frequently and bumps into air molecules next to it. Those air molecules then bump into the air molecules over there. These molecules bump into those molecules, and much like dominoes, molecules bump each other until they get all the way to your ear. Keep in mind, the molecules themselves aren't traveling across the room. They're just bumping into each other, and those subsequent bumps eventually bump molecules that then hit your ear. That's what a sound wave is. But what's pitch? Why do low notes get us so excited? When a speaker cone vibrates very quickly, the air molecules next to it end up vibrating at the same rate, and that rate of vibration remains consistent all the way until it hits your eardrum, which you would hear as high pitch. If it vibrates less quickly, less frequently, you hear that as low pitch. So the faster a speaker cone is vibrating, the higher pitched it sounds. But we still haven't figured out why low frequency notes are so exciting. Here's where we get to the nitty-gritty of that answer. Our ears are not as sensitive to low frequency notes as they are to higher frequency notes. This means at a concert, in order to get the low frequency notes sounding as loud as the higher frequencies, the sound guys have to put in a lot of energy to the subwoofers to make it compete with the treble. This means that those low frequency sound waves are extremely powerful. There's a lot of energy per second in those sound waves. This means that bass waves are capable of doing all kinds of things that treble waves are not. For example, when you breathe in and out, your chest expands and contracts. Your chest is kind of like a kid on a swing. It goes back and forth. When high frequency waves get to your chest, it's kind of like pushing a kid on a swing like this. The kid's not going to go anywhere. But when low frequency waves get to your chest, it's like giving the kid on a swing a good energetic push every second or two. Soon enough, the kid's going to start swinging. Well, so does your chest. Your chest expands and contracts at the same rate that those low frequency sound waves are hitting it. If you were to film your chest with a slow-mo camera, you would see it contracting and expanding at a rate of 20 or 30 times per second. This feels very intense. This means that bass waves are capable of doing things that treble waves are not. So when Skrillex gets to the drop, there are physical things that happen in your body that don't happen in other parts of the song. Remember all that energy that the sound guys had to pump into those low frequency waves to get you to hear them so they competed with the volume of the high frequency waves? Well, guess where that energy ends up? Shaking your chest back and forth. In other words, during a bass drop, you're not only hearing music, you're feeling it in your body. And that feels fun, kind of like getting pushed on a swing. If you're a physics student in a so-called flipped classroom, or actually even if you're not in a flipped classroom, make sure to check out the Radical Physics video series because it can be really useful. And let your teacher know that the episodes cover all the key ideas and they can be used as your classroom physics lecture series. Check out the Radical Physics video series right here.
When you understand the laws of physics, Penny, anything is possible.